Hey everyone, I'm Ruth. Welcome back to another video. In this tutorial, I am painting a seascape with dunes and grass in watercolors. If you want to learn how to paint this seascape yourself, I will show you step by step how to do it. So, let's get started. I start by drawing a line for the horizon and I loosely draw in the dunes with pencil. Then I wet the sky area and start with very diluted paint to paint in the sky. The color I am using is cobalt blue. Then I pre-wet the dunes. And here also I start with a very light layer of diluted paint. And for this I use the colors yellow ochre and raw umber. When this layer is dry, I start with the sea. First, I erase some pencil so that won't show through in the painting. And then I start by painting in a light layer of paint in the sea. And for this, I use emerald green and cobalt blue. Now I mix in some cadmium yellow and paint another layer on the dunes with very diluted paint again. And some more raw umber and yellow ochre. And when this layer is dry, I paint another layer on the sea, same colors as before, and another layer on the dunes. Now I mix some sap green and raw umber and paint this on the dunes. And also a little bit of Indian red. And some more yellow ochre. I keep doing this to build up layers to create depth in my painting. And I do the same with the sea. And when this layer is dry, I paint another layer on the sea and also on the dunes, again to create depth. And when this layer is dry, I use a very tiny brush to paint in the grass. This layer is still very light, and later on I will darken it up. For this grass, I use a mixture of different colors: sap green, yellow ochre, and also raw umber. I also use the colors that I have used for the dunes and mix it in the grass. I use a very tiny brush to paint in this grass. I use the Rembrandt series 110, number 1. But you can, of course, also choose another brush, as long as it is really tiny, so you can paint in a lot of detail and small blades of grass. Now I start to darken up the grass, and I do that by mixing sap green and raw umber, and I don't dilute it so much anymore. This just means less water and more paint. Now I darken up the dunes a little more, and I forgot to tell you before, but I use the Rembrandt series 135 number 2 for this. And I use some Indian red to darken up the dunes. And I go on with darkening the grass with various shades of green, just a mixture of the colors I mentioned before. And I also use my Indian red, just darkening the grass up. And as you can see, I use all of the colors I already have on my palette. And I use the Indian red mainly to darken up the roots of the grass. And although the wind is blowing the grass in one direction, I make sure that I also paint some grass going in the other direction. Or else it will look really strange, really unrealistic. I just repeat the process. Darkening the grass up and also the sand underneath. And I always start very light in my watercolor paintings, because it's really easy to go from light to dark, but it's almost impossible to go from dark to light. And when this layer is dry, I repeat the whole process again and keep adding layers to my grass. And as I said before, also some grass in the other direction. And here I go in with my Indian red again to even darken it more. Now I take some white gouache and paint in some waves on the sea. And with a mixture of blue and green, I paint a shadow underneath these waves. It's a mixture of cobalt blue and emerald green. And another layer of paint on the grass, to give it more definition and make it look realistic. And I just keep adding layers until I am happy with the result. Some final details on the grass. And then I'm ready to take off the tape. And this is the final result. Thank you very much for watching my video. If you liked it, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you have a comment, please leave it down below. And you can share my video with all your friends. Thank you. Bye.